Hi, my name is Gareth Spence. I'm currently in San Diego at OFC. I'm standing on ADVA's booth, and I'm talking to industry analysts Roy Rubenstein and Daryl Innes. They're also the authors of the book Silicon Photonics, Fueling the Next Information Revolution. Gentlemen, thanks for joining me today. I'd like to start by asking why you wrote the book. What attracted you to Silicon Photonics?
Silicon Photonics is an exciting area because it brings together a number of fields, electronics, optics, but it also brings in this whole business aspect. So it's not just a technology issue that's happening in the marketplace that has the potential of disrupting this industry, but it also is an area where there's serious thoughts that's needed to help transform the industry to a place where it can really make differentiation in people's lives.
Okay, reading the book, it doesn't read like a textbook in any way. It's quite distinct, it's not dry. Was that a deliberate choice from you guys?
It is a deliberate choice. We had a type of person in mind that we wanted to write the book for, and we kept that picture in our mind. So we didn't want to write a textbook, and we didn't want a collection of academic papers. We were trying to explain to a wide community what silicon photonics is all about, and we knew that this is a technology that would impact more than one industry. So we took care to explain to the technology to a variety of audiences, and to do that, you had to write it in a very, very simple way, but at the same time go into some depth. So we were conscious that we had to take care of a wide audience when it came to this book. And that's what we tried to do, to add value to what we were writing, but at the same time take into account that not everyone would be a specialist in all the areas.
Okay. And without giving too much away, for those that haven't read it, what were the main takeaways of the book?
I think the one area for me, the main takeaway was the consideration that the market is going to transform in a way where electronics actually starts to encapsulate photonics. This is obviously something that can take many years, but it was a revelation to me. It's not something that I went in thinking that would happen, but by the time we got to the end, it became clear that, this is reality.
You wrote the book in 2017, or 2016, it was published in 2017. How has the market evolved since that time?
In one sense, it's been a relatively quiet period for silicon photonics, or at least on the surface. And we did look a little bit further ahead, but we are now starting to see some of the things we were expecting to see, and especially at this OFC. So there are things that are happening that we thought would happen and which is actually coming to be. So the technology is moving on. Plus there's been an important acquisition with Cisco acquiring Luxtera, and there's a reason why they've acquired Luxtera. So these are all pointers that it is going in the direction of becoming more important. Plus, when you talk to more companies here, they are using silicon photonics. And when we did the book 2-3 years ago, they weren't using silicon photonics.
In the book, you talk about silicon photonics reaching a tipping point in 2021. Do you still think we're on track to see that happen?
Yeah, I think we're still on track. Things may change. We may be off by a year or two, but I don't think it's substantially different from what we've said. As the demand for data continues to increase, particularly for data centers, this is the approach. This is the way to reduce power consumption, reduce size, reduce cost. And so there's nothing that we've seen so far that suggests that this is not the path.
And what do you see in regards to the investment cycle around silicon photonics?
You could argue that the Cisco's acquisition, it was over $600 million, but companies are adding this technology to what they're already doing. They're not going to necessarily make these chips. And this is perhaps an indicator of the power of the technology, that companies can embrace this and suddenly become optical players, whereas perhaps before there weren't obviously optical players. So the investment is happening across the board incrementally. Companies are embracing the technologies. Foundries are starting to open up because the volumes are starting to happen. So again, it's not rapid change, but it's all going in the direction of this technology being adopted in this step-by-step way, and this is what we're seeing.
So, I mean, both TSMC adopting the technology, working with Luxtera, for example, STMicro, and then we have GlobalFoundries working with Ayar Labs. I mean, these are some of the major foundries in the world, and there are public announcements about them working with in silicon photonics.
And do you still believe that silicon photonics will play a pivotal role in tomorrow's data center architectures?
It will do as speed of chips and interfaces become faster and faster. And that's what we're picking up at this show that perhaps wasn't the case a year ago and certainly 2 years ago. People were talking about that, but in the future. Now people are starting to talk about that more seriously. So it's going to take time, but most definitely.
And in the book, you talk about killer applications evolving for silicon photonics. Have there been any killer applications that you've seen since you published?
I think fundamentally, the driver is telecommunications. There's no question about it. And so whether you include data communications and what's happening with data centers or not, that's where the market is. But in general, for optics, for this type of optics, that's the bulk of the market. What is changing is the advent of new opportunities. So for example, the so-called autonomous everything, whether it's in LiDAR or whether it's in sensing, whether it's in gyroscopes, there are other areas where silicon photonics, or should I in general say integrated photonics, is playing a significant role. And while from a revenue perspective and from a market expansion in terms of growth, we don't see it yet, this is to come. And there are many companies out there outside of this communications market space that's playing roles there.
If I can just add to that, there is no killer app as such as yet, but what has definitely come into focus is the advent of 51 terabit switch chips. Now, this is coming, they don't exist yet, but they're very close on the horizon, as in 3-4 years away. And that is the first application where people see that optics needs to be done differently to be brought right next to the chip. And that's where silicon, so this is a significant step in the evolution of silicon photonics. And already people are starting to worry about it. So that's not a killer app, but it's the closest we've come to an identifiable killer app.
Okay, and what's next for you guys? Will there be a volume two? Is there anything else in the works?
Well, it's a good question. I mean, frankly, we've been talking about this for the last 2+ years. To write this book, to get it done, I think both of our personal lives changed significantly, in which case, to get the energy up, to think about what it is exactly we would want to say, how we would address the market going forward, these are challenges. And so we have to answer those questions both from a personal perspective and also from the perspective of looking at the market and saying, what does the market need, right? What would people read and why would they read this? And so we're having these debates probably, I don't know, it could be weekly to monthly now, but I expect that we will author another book.
Okay, look forward to that. Gentlemen, thank you for your time today and for talking about silicon photonics. Appreciate it.